Given the cost of living crisis, please tell us what specific actions are being taken by the council to increase community resilience over the forthcoming winter period.
Thank you, Chair. One of the council's most important priorities is to work relentlessly to promote prosperity, enabling people to access opportunities through skills development and employment is crucial. The council's approach to addressing concerns about the cost of living will be focused on supporting people to enhance their life chances. To do this, there must be a focus on local economic growth. That is why the council's economic development strategy, to be published next year, will set out a plan to attract further inward investment in the town. The council is also setting up an internal working group to look at what practical action can be taken regarding the cost of living. One step already taken by the council has been to further fund the community hub to ensure this outreach provision for residents will continue through the winter, connecting residents with sources of help and support. The council continues to have a good working relationship with citizens of Bus Harlow and the town's food bank, where some hub users are referred, alongside the offer of mental health support. Further opportunities are being explored through the council's work with colleagues in primary care and on the Harlow Health and Wellbeing Partnership, and also colleagues on the West Essex Health Partnership structures. The council is also engaging with a local poverty alliance and listening to the issues raised to look at ways to assist. A separate meeting request has been sent to the leading members of the poverty alliance to discuss what more the council can do to help residents during the winter months. The council's website has been updated to include support and advice about the cost of living, and this will continue to develop. Projects under current consideration are the development of a campaign throughout the winter to ensure that residents can get the right advice on a range of matters, including additional benefits information, fuel efficiency and insulation best practice, and debt and mental health support. These matters have already been highlighted in the Harlow Times, and further information will be posted on the council's social media channels. As part of the council's winter planning, the provision of warm spaces for vulnerable residents who may need support is being considered. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Rivers, have you got a supplementary to that?
I have. Given that in your answer you mentioned both the Poverty Alliance, the discussions with the Poverty Alliance, and the provision of warm spaces, what more do you anticipate the council will be doing, and what is the timetable, and when will that be published for any actions that the council will be taking?
Thank you, Chair. Councillors, I think that's a really important point as we've now headed into the winter months.
Yeah.
The plan that we have decided to take forward is to work closely with those people, those community leaders on the ground. And I think the Poverty Alliance offers a mechanism for that, hence why we are having that meeting with them. Because what I want to do is any action by the council is done in collaboration with the charitable sector, our faith groups, just so that we get a good rounded picture of where the support needs to be for our more vulnerable residents in the town. In terms of the warm spaces initiative that the council wants to pursue, one of the options we are considering is the playhouse. What we want to do though is understand where the resources need to be targeted. That has to be done with community leaders. I'm open, of course, to being close contact with you, Councillor, if it is my opposite number, so that I understand what we're trying to do to help individuals in the town with the cost of living. And then I open that to